Learning Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 2026, my favorite formula in all of Excel. I'm podcasting this entire book. Click the I in the top right hand corner to get to the playlist. All right. It was the 30th topic in the book. We were kind of at the end of the formula section, or in the midst of the formula section, and I said, I have to include my favorite formula of all time. This is just an amazing formula. Whether you have to count the number Friday the 13th or not, it opens a world into a whole secret area of Excel called array formulas. Put in a start date, put in an end date, and this formula calculates the number of Friday the 13th that occurred between those two dates. It's actually doing five calculations on every single day between those two dates, 91,895 calculations plus a sum, 91,896 calculations happening inside of this one little formula. All right, now, by the end of this episode, you're going to be so intrigued by array formulas. I want to point out my friend Mike Gervin has the best book on array formulas called Ctrl+Shift+Enter. This is a recent printing with a blue cover. It used to be a yellow and green cover. Whichever one you get is a great book. Same content in both the yellow and the green one. All right, so let's start out on the inside of this with a formula you may not have heard called INDIRECT. INDIRECT allows us to concatenate or in some way build a bit of text that looks like a cell reference. All right, so let's say we have a prize wheel here, and I just ask you to choose between A, B, and C. All right, so you choose this and choose C, and then choose this and choose 3. All right, and your prize is a resort stay because that's what's stored in C3. And the formula here is concatenating together whatever's in C5 and whatever's in C6 using the ampersand, and then passing that to the indirect. So equal indirect of C5 and C6, in this case, is C3. That has to be a valid cell reference. Indirect says, hey, we're going to go to C3 and return the answer from that. All right. Back in Lotus 1-2-3, this was called at function. In Excel, they renamed it to be indirect. All right, so you have in the indirect. Now, here's the amazing thing that's happening inside of there. We have two dates. How does Excel store dates? 2/17/1965, that's really just formatting. If we went and looked at the actual number behind that, it is 23,790, which means that it is 23,790 days since January 1st, 1900, and 42,160 days since January 1st, 1900 on a Windows PC. On a Mac, it'll be since January 1st, 1904, so the dates will be about 3,000 off. All right, that's how Excel stores it. It's showing it to us, though, thanks to this number format, as a date. But if we would concatenate together B3 and a colon and B4, it would actually give us the numbers stored behind the scenes. So equal B3 ampersand quote colon quote ampersand B4. And if we would pass that to indirect, it's actually going to point to all rows from 23,790 down to 42,167. So there's the indirect of B6. I asked for the row of that. That's going to give me a whole bunch of answers. And to figure out how many answers, I use count. All right. And in order to make this work, if I just press Enter, it doesn't work. I have to hold down Control and Shift and press Enter. And see, that adds the curly braces around the formula up here. It tells Excel to go into super formula mode, array formula mode, and do all of the math for everything popped out from that array. 18,378. All right, so that is an amazing trick. Indirect of date 1 colon date 2, pass that to the row function. And here's a small example. So we just want to figure out how many Fridays occurred in this July. Here's a start date, here's an end date, and for each of those rows I'm going to ask for the weekday. Tells us what day of the week it is. And here in the colon or comma 2 argument, Fridays will have a value of 5. So I'm looking for the answer, and we're going to choose this formula, go to formulas, and evaluate formula. And evaluate formula is a great way to watch a formula get calculated in slow motion. So there's the B3, the July 1st, and you see that changes to a number. and then we join the colon, great. There's the before, that'll change to a number. And now we get the text of 42,186 to 42,216. At this point, we pass that to the row, and that simple little expression is going to turn into 31 values right here. Now, in the example where I had everything from 1965 to 2015, it would pop out 86,000 values, right? And you don't want to do that in evaluate formula because it would be kind of insane, all right? But you can see what's happening here with the 31. And now I'm passing those 31 days to the weekday function. And we get 3, 4, 5. So 3 means that it was a Wednesday. And then 4 means it was a Thursday. And then 5 means it was a Friday. Take all those 31 values and see if they're equal to 5, which is a Friday. And we're going to get a bunch of falses and trues. False, false, true. So Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And then 7 cells later, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 will be the next true. Awesome. All right, so in this case, we have 5 trues and 26 falses. In order to add those up, I need to convert the falses to zeros and the trues to 1. And a very common way to do that is to use the minus minus. All right, now it didn't show the answer there where we saw a whole bunch of ones and zeros, but that actually is what happens. And then sum product adds it up and gets us to the 5 down here. If we want to figure out how many 13ths of the month there were this year from this start date to this end date, very similar process, although we're going to have 365, pass that to the day function and check to see how many are 13. All right, so for the 92,000 row example, we're getting the day, we're getting the weekday, checking to see if the day is equal to 13, checking to see if the weekday is false, multiplying this times this, and only in the cases where it's a Friday the 13th does that end up as true. The sum product then says add all those up, and that's how we get the 86. Literally, 91,895 calculations plus the sum, 91,896 happening inside of this one formula. It's crazy powerful. Go buy Mike's book. It's an amazing book. It will open an entire world of Excel formulas to you. And actually, you should just buy both books. Buy my book, buy Mike's book, and you will have an awesome collection that will get you through the rest of the year. All right, so recap. There's a secret class of formulas called array formulas. An array formula can do thousands of intermediate calculations. They usually require you to press Ctrl+Shift+Enter, but not always. And the best book on array formulas is Mike Gervin's Ctrl+Shift+Enter book. All right, so indirect lets you use concatenation to build something that looks like a cell reference, and then indirect goes to that cell reference. Concatenating two dates with a colon will point to a range of rows in Excel. And then asking for the row of the indirect of date 1 colon date 2 will pop out an array of many consecutive numbers. Maybe 31, maybe 365, or maybe 85,000. Check each date to see if the weekday is Friday. Check each date to see if the day is 13. Multiply those two arrays of trues and falses using the sum product. And in many cases, we'll use minus minus to convert the true falses to ones and zeros to allow the sum product to work. It's an awesome formula. I didn't create it. I found it on the Mr. Excel message board. And as I worked through it, I'm like, wow, this is really cool. All right. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.